So the first important point of the book is the history of the African Americans. It states that initially people of African descent were used as servants, then they became slaves, then they were the lowest part of society, then after they were emancipated, they advanced with education, and then after the civil rights movement, due to a lack of emphasis on education, their progress relatively to other peoples halted. The second interesting point is the history of the South. So what happened is that the people in the South inherited the barbarian culture. So the majority of individuals were from the war-torn region that's located between England and Scotland. Usually there were a lot of clashes there, and the barbarian culture was inherited in the South. The third point that's very interesting is the differences between the African-American groups. So there was a difference between the blacks living up north and the blacks living in south. Also, there was a difference between individuals who came from the Caribbean islands. The fourth point is the history of slavery. So when slavery comes to mind, you think of white individuals enslaving black individuals in southern states, chances are. However, all races have been slaveholders or have been enslaved in some point of history. The fifth point the author made was an emphasis of the importance of education. The example given was that of Dunbar High School. So individuals attending this high school scored higher on tests than the national average at the time. And these individuals were from African descent. And furthermore, their families were from the lower income groups. So it stated that the emphasis is placed on hard work, discipline, and education. No matter what the background or environment of the person, they will progress in life. The sixth point is the misunderstood role of middlemen. Now this is a really big point because this cleared up a lot of misconceptions. When you think of moneylenders, maybe you think of the Jewish population. Their roles are considered parasitic, the money lending, because they do not create anything. However, this role is quite important because in certain situations, people starved to death because they did not have access to capital. And middlemen, such as the Jews, were really important middlemen. The last important point, the author clears up the misconception that the exploitation of others is what advanced Western civilization. So the point the author makes is this. Let's just say that the Aborigines people or the Native American population would have not been conquered and would have not interacted with the world today. Then what would their situation be today if they wouldn't have had that Western contact? And what would the situation of the Western world be if they wouldn't have colonized Africa, Australia, or conquered the Native Americans? Chances are that the European population would be better off to a greater extent than the people who were colonized or conquered. The last point. These were the seven most important points of Thomas Sowell's Rednecks and White Liberals book. There's a longer version, and I provided the link for it in the description below. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe.